quickly get into a very interesting session and welcome a very, very interesting speaker. Now, who is the person? Quickly, I'll tell you a little story about the person and his partner who started this. Well, with no intentions earlier to do this, they got into this because they had a personal experience about something. And then the couple decided, let's take a next level, to make sure the consumers get the best than what has been served to them already. And today, in 2021, they are top-notch in bringing products which are with... Well, the lack of safe baby products I was talking to you about, which led Varun and Ghazal Alag to create Mama Earth in 2016 and offer parents toxin-free products for their tiny tots. Since then, the brand has seen an exponential growth, become one of the most talked about brands in the country, and remain committed to its brand philosophy of goodness inside, telling us why consumers connect with purpose-driven brands is the man himself, Varun Alag, co-founder and CEO of Hanusa Consumer Private Limited, the makers of Mama Earth and the Derma Company. Please welcome with a big round of applause, Varun Alag with us this evening. Hi Varun, good evening to you and very, very happy to have you here with us right now.
Hey, good evening. Thank you so much for having me here. And thank you for those kind words of setting up some really kind things that you had to say about what we have done and what we have built. And thank you for that.
So Varun, I'm talking with my personal experience itself. I have a little niece at home and we are very attached to your products. And I can totally get the difference of when I was born, I did not have this. But now that I have it, I would rather give it to the coming generation as well. So I know how great the products are. And today, as you join us here, you know, all our audience and me, mostly all of us, are eagerly waiting to understand the story and what more do you bring to the table. So over to you, Arun, and post which I'll have a bunch of questions ready for you for sure.
Super. So let me actually go back and start from the story itself, and then I'll jump in to talk about our belief in purpose-based brands. And why they matter to millennials and how at least we look at building purpose-based brands, sharing you the secret framework of doing that internally and with the audience as well. And this story, like Mithun talked about, goes back to honestly 2014, not 2016. And 2014 is when we were blessed with Agastya, our son, and that's when the platonic relationship with personal care became a little more serious for us, and because before that, while you know, I've been in the industry, I've worked with Unilever, sold shampoos, conditioners, lotions, etc., but never really cared to check the ingredients that go in there. And
are you with us, Varun?
Because kids have 2x the transdermal absorption compared to adults, and they are at even higher risk from some of this these chemicals, and that kind of made us think. We of course, like anyone else would, we started ordering stuff from abroad and tried to figure a way around this problem that we were facing. And but after trying to latch on to a lot of friends, relatives, etc., we realized it was really painful and expensive as well. And so we finally sort of started talking about this idea that someone should solve this, and not only the problem of creating toxin-free products, and but also problem of creating great personal care products meant for India, meant for Indian problems, coming from the cultural heritage that we come from. For example, as parents, we would use the mix of hing and coconut oil on our son's tummy for better digestion and for colic relief, and we didn't want to give him anything to sort of consume at that time, because as much as possible you want to avoid, they're only on mother's milk, right? But there was nothing available in the market which could easily solve that. If we had to do that late at the night, we had to get up and sort of do it, right? We wanted to build a brand which would understand these pain points of consumers, right? And build for that, right? Rather than starting the build idea from assuming what is the kind of market size and how will I get share in that market size, right? Rather than starting from that as a assumption, starting from an assumption, what do people need, right? And how do I solve that, right? All of these, the problem became passion, and that passion became this brand. 2016 is when we left our full-time job, started working on this, and at the end of the year is when we launched Mama Earth as Asia's first MadeSafe certified brand with a set of baby care products. And since the beginning, one of the core things, apart from listening to consumers, being digital first, that we have been married to, so to say, and is that this century belongs to why-based brands and not what-based brands, and which is actually my segue into purpose-based brands, right? So we believe that in the last century, a lot of brands that were created were largely actually category creations, right? Where you were trying to explain to a consumer, hey, what is a shampoo, right? And why should they use it, right? Especially when you look at Indian market. And you were trying to create categories. And when you're trying to create categories, it's the what that matters. And now, at the evolution that we are at, where there is strong penetration when it comes to category development, and people are not as bothered about a what, right? They know it's a shampoo and it cleanses, right? They're more bothered about the why, right? As to when they buy into the brand, right? What are they buying into? And what would they talk about when they have to tell the story of their choice to themselves or to someone else, right? And which is where why sort of comes into play, right? And when people, and there are a lot of examples of this change happening. Apple is a great example of a why-based brand, right? And when you buy into Apple's design philosophy, you buy into whatever Apple sells. It's not just phones, you'd buy into that ecosystem. Back home in India, what Patanjali was doing was again a great example of a why-based brand when being built, because you were buying, whichever households were buying into the why and were actually buying then Patanjali across categories. And so that's a strong belief that we have, that millennials will want to find differentiators beyond what, right? And that differentiator is going to lie in the why and how of brands, right? Rather than what you're selling. And as why and how becomes more important in making some of these brand choices, and is where purpose sort of comes into play. And that's what we've been married to since we started. And we've been building a purposeful brand. And Goodness Inside has been that the culmination or encapsulation of that purpose. And Mama Earth, is born out of that purpose. Right? And that purpose actually, the framework that we use internally, and which I'll talk about in terms of explaining how we are sort of then building and communicating the purpose-based brand is on three P's structure. And the first P is product, right? How does the brand live its purpose through the product, right? So if Goodness Inside is a purpose philosophy, then at a product level, it basically means that there is no nasties in this product and it's only goodness inside, right? And from the product construct perspective. And that is very important, that your purpose shouldn't lie only in your communications. It has to start from your product. And then comes the how, right? Which is processes, right? Which is where we have multiple pieces which point back to the goodness inside way of life that Mama Earth believes in, right? So we are a PETA certified brand. We don't test on animals, and we are a plastic positive brand. We recycle more plastic than we consume. In fact, last month, for example, we would have helped recycle 120 tons of plastic. And we have a first in the world initiative called Plant Goodness, and where every time you place an order on our website, we actually link it back to a tree that we have planted. And we send a picture of that tree, a geolocation of that tree to you in your email, right? So that you can actually see the contribution that you have made to the world, not just to yourself by buying great products, right? But also to the environment because of the action that you took. And now that's our how, right? Which is our processes part where goodness inside comes to life because of these things that we do. And then there is the part about perspective, and which is really where the why sort of lies. And this is where the brand brings forward its point of view or a cultural point of view into the world. And where we believe goodness is an action, right? Goodness is a choice. And hence for us, beauty. And while for some other brands, it could be beauty could be how you look. And for some other brands, beauty could be how you feel. And but for Mama Earth, right, beauty is a verb. And hence beauty is what you do that makes you beautiful rather than how you look or how you feel. And that's the big perspective and point of view through which we want to sort of, you know, communicate our purpose and connect emotionally with our consumers. And when you communicate all of these things together, you know, across multimedia, is when you're able to get a consumer to connect with your why. You know, when they buy into your why, then, like I said, they'll buy whatever from you, not just what. And they will also have a strong story to tell. When someone asks them why this, then they will be actually able to tell them that this is the reason why I believe I buy this brand. And we'll see this philosophy shaping up far more in India over the next couple of decades. As categories evolve, as brands evolve, as the digital ecosystem further evolves. And in US, for example, there are great examples of Tom's Shoes or Patagonia, right? And Seven Generation, where some of these purpose stories have played really well. And we believe, in the next couple of decades, it's the time for purpose-based brands to sort of, you know, take shape and do exceptionally well. And especially with the onslaught of social media, and which is really all about storytelling, right? I mean, it is social which has turned into media. And earlier, Avatar social used to live in form of word of mouth, and which used to be conversations about conversation worthy stuff. And you would not do conversations, the fact that you've used something which was a what based or something which was good at cleansing in the morning, right? But you would have conversations about conversations worthy stuff, and that's what social media helps you do. And we have seen the influencer ecosystem, the social ecosystem shaping really well to again support these purpose-based brands, right? and to provide impetus to how they will take shape in future. And we have closely used some of these engines to get our story out there, to spread it in the right manner. And we will continue to do more of that as we sort of get into future. I think in a short, sweet summary, that is what I had to say from a purpose perspective. And how we believe building purpose-based brands is going to be extremely, useful for all, large CPG companies, as well as it's a way through which we'll all end up driving a 360 impact rather than just impacting, top lines and bottom lines, right? We'll actually be able to have a triple bottom line impact as well. And hopefully we will see a lot more purpose-based brands getting built over the next decade.
Right. Thank you so much, Varun Alakh. I think last 15 minutes you spoke out everything that was in my mind, but I just have one question that is coming in. Your market is, your TG is consumers in tier one and tier two cities, but tier three is still a long way to go is what I see. What are your plans for tier three city in the coming days?
Actually, I wouldn't say tier three is far away from us. In fact, especially during the last 12 months, and we have seen our tier three and beyond contributions to go up significantly. In fact, from a contribution perspective, it has gone up by 50% and in the last 12 months. And we now are servicing more than 2,500 towns across India, and from our own platform itself, and then beyond that, the other e-commerce platforms would be adding further reach to this number, and even physically from an offline presence perspective, we are there in close to 100 cities, right? All the smart cities which are there, and so especially the last 12 months, we have seen a lot of positive pull for the brand because of what it stands for, what it believes in, and you know, people are clearly looking for options which are safer, more natural, and have a positive impact on the society. And so because of that, we have seen a lot of pull from all quarters, not just a tier one and tier two specific quarter.
So 2020 must be the year where, you know, the numbers would have increased, the business would have increased, the consumer requirements must have increased, because a lot of babies were born in the month, in the year 2020. I'm sure you agree with that, right? Right, Varun? So where do you see 2021 going from here?
In fact, one of the things that I must qualify is that while we started as a baby care brand, and baby care is one part of our portfolio now, and it contributes, you know, about 20-odd% to the brand. And our adult skincare, adult hair care, body care business is actually fairly large as well. And that is what a why-based brand sort of, you know, helps you do, right? Because when consumers start buying into the brand, they'll start buying it for the whole family. And when they start using it themselves, they'll start referring it to their friends, relatives, you know, and hence the categories also sort of, you know, start spreading. So the same person who's buying baby care is also buying stuff from themselves, right? So it's actually expanded quite a lot in terms of scope. We have over 200 products now. And from our 2021 perspective, yes, I think going further deep and building the awareness funnel would be one of the core objectives, right? And hence, outside, while 2020, large part of our advertising was limited to digital mediums, right? You will also see us going live aggressively on traditional mediums like TV in 2021, and to push out our awareness into deeper quarters, as well as to provide cover for the horizontal and offline distribution that we intend to do.
So in the coming days, I'm going to see a lot of TV commercials. That's going to be all about your brand and products, I'm sure.
Yes, absolutely. They're already on, by the way.
They're already on. Okay. So I think I'm missing out completely for sure. But Varun, thank you for joining us here. One last thing I have in mind. There's so much you're doing for, if I look at it from a prospect where you're serving to environment, you're doing so much more across. It's about 2 days back was the World Water Day. So did you do anything special about those days? Do you celebrate these days in your organization?
Also, honestly, we strongly believe that there are few things that if you can do them really well, rather than doing everything to a little extent, then it makes a much bigger difference like that. We also believe that, you know, in the longer term, we are building a company which will have a house of brands. Mama Earth has chosen its play around a certain areas of, let's say, environment or sustainability where it is making an impact. And there are going to be other brands which will stand for and which will take stand on some of the other issues, right? Could be varied from water conservation to you know, party to education, to girl child, you know, we don't know. But the view is that over time, and the house of brands and will try to make as much difference to the society because of the brands that we sell and how they contribute back. And hence, as a company, we'll have a much wider footprint in being able to make that dent.
As you say this, Varun, I have no doubt about it. And so the consumer of a country who has no doubt that, you know what, Mama Earth and the entire Derma company that you're leading right now is got so much more in the coming future. Thank you so much for joining us here. It was great talking to you. And I can't wait to meet you in person and discuss much more in terms of what's the plan like for the coming days and coming year. But thank you so much for joining us. And I wish you great luck for the year 2021 to you and your partner and your entire team. Thank you so much again.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure being here.